Welcome back. Now, in his 30-year career, he's gone from playing to just four people in a pub in Carlisle to selling out the Albert Hall, still probably the most successful British musician that most people have never heard of.
Stephen Wilson is his name, and he's been dubbed the King of Prog Rock, and his new album is expected to go straight to the top of the charts. We're going to talk to him. Morning.
Hello there.
Let's listen to his work first. Stephen, welcome.
Thank you
for
having me.
Good morning. What's prog rock?
I've no idea. Well, actually, no, I do have an idea. Prog rock for me is telling stories through music and using the album as a kind of something for me that's analogous with making a movie or writing a novel. It's the long form. So you can take the listener on a musical journey that doesn't kind of constrict you to the 3-minute pop form. So for me, that's my definition of progressive.
So, talking about musical journeys, we mentioned four people in a pub in Carlisle.
Yeah.
Is that true?
It was a Tuesday night, it was raining, and there was four people. So, yes, it's true, yeah.
And there's you.
It was a long time ago.
I love the scene, though. Yeah. You're on stage with the keyboard.
With a guitar.
With a guitar.
With a guitar, yes, yeah.
And then just four people there.
Well, I think it's called paying your dues, and I've certainly paid my dues, yeah.
Yeah.
And now you're, well, anticipated to be at number one.
Which is insane, I know, it's crazy.
Why are you the person, the most, what did we say, the most prolific person, most successful British musician that most people have never heard of?
Because I think we already touched on it, this idea of progressive rock is it's a kind of music which exists very much outside of the mainstream,
right,
because it is about the long form. And, you know, if you want to get on the radio and be in the mainstream, you will very much have to focus on this more concise pop form.
Did Pink Floyd manage to do it?
A different era, though.
I
think the late 60s, the 70s was an era where that kind of music could kind of proliferate because it wasn't about so much about pop and mainstream. Nowadays, I think attention spans are a little bit shorter. You know, we live in the age of the internet. So if you don't kind of conform to that format, then there's really no kind of platform for you to reach people.
But then people who are new to your music, maybe people watching this now, who saw that glimpse we saw a moment ago,
yes,
that felt like something that was very very easy to access.
That is, you know, yes, that is my ABBA moment.
What does that mean?
It means, well, because I grew up in a house where my dad would listen to things like Dark Side of the Moon and Tubular Bells by Mike Oldfield. My mum would listen to things like ABBA and The Carpenters. And I grew up with both, and I love both. They're both in my DNA. But for whatever reason, most of my career, I seem to have tended towards the more conceptual rock side. But for the first time on this album, I've managed to write what, for me, is a convincing piece of pure, joyous pop music.
Nice. And is that it sounds like, the way you talk about it, it sounds like that's...
I'm very proud of it.
A happy thing.
Oh, I'm very proud of it, yeah.
Good. So, conceptual album or conceptual song, piece of music.
Yeah.
What's the concept?
This album, I mean, like a lot of people at the moment, I think I'm looking around at the world I live in and seeing the problems. So, there is an element that runs right through the album, which is all about this idea of truth as perception. What we call truth very often isn't truth at all. It's filtered through our own agenda, our gender, our race, our politics, our religion, our upbringing. So all of the songs kind of focus on this idea of truth as perception.
We're going to listen to Pariah,
okay,
from the new album, and then tell me how that fits in,
okay,
to the story.
Sure.
Here we go. So there are no words?
Well, there is in the song. That clip you picked is the instrumental sort of.
Okay,
coda,
so yeah. How does that fit in the
so
album?
So that song is, although we didn't see it, that song is a duet between a man and a woman, and it's all about if you take the idea of truth as perception to its most kind of intimate format, you look at a relationship, and how the two people in the relationship have a completely different perception of how the relationship is working. So their truth is very different.
How long? Sorry, one more, and then I'll.
Go ahead.
How long does it take you to put together a conceptual album?
It takes me a long time because I'm looking, you know, I'm looking for something that, you know, we talked about the idea of the album as a journey. And very often it's not a question of putting your best music, it's a question of putting the music that makes the most sense as a kind of cohesive whole. You know, like sometimes directors talk about they had to cut their favourite scene out of a movie because it just didn't work in context. So it's kind of like that for me too. So it's almost like putting a jigsaw puzzle together.
And how's the spotlight thing working for you? The attention, here you are, you know, on breakfast television, people are putting a face to the music and, you know,
yeah.
There's something quite nice, I would imagine, as a musician, there's something quite nice about being slightly in the shadows. And now, that's all gone, isn't it?
Well, it hasn't all gone. I mean, you know, this is kind of very unusual for me to be here today. Listen, I mean, I think one of the things about making music, if you really believe in what you do, and you're really passionate about it, there's a natural inclination to want to share it with as many people as possible. So although I've been happy in a way being relatively anonymous, I've also had that frustration that I've always felt like there's a lot of people out there that if they had the opportunity to hear the music would like it, but they simply haven't. So this is all, I'm enjoying this.
Good. Well, lovely to see you this morning.
Thank you very much for having me.
And you want this to get to number one, obviously.
Of course, who wouldn't?
Good luck.
Thank you.
Fingers crossed for you.
Thank you.
Steve. And Stephen's new album is called To The Bone.
That's it from us.